So are you able to see this interface, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, welcome back. In today's lecture, basically I'm going to talk about the free will arbitrary time stability and stabilization. So after this lecture, we hope that we are able to understand the connection between stability, asymptotic stability, exponential stability, finite time stability, fixed time stability, and that is highest form of stability, that is called free will arbitrary time stability. So let us start the lecture. So if you remember that this is my favorite system, so most of time I am taking underwater vehicle, and after that I am trying to give several idea using this very simple example. So this is mathematical model. Several time I have discussed about this mathematical model. So, and I am assuming that weight of this particular underwater vehicle, I have assumed that is unity, and we know that our aim to design thruster here or design control such that I am able to steer this underwater vehicle from one point to another point. And since I have to just control the velocity, so either I have to maintain some constant velocity or time varying velocity. And due to that reason, either I have tracking problem or a stabilization problem. So we have already seen that what is meaning of tracking problem and a stabilization problem. Already I have given a lot of emphasis on this. So here, this class of problem is basically robust tracking or robust stabilization problem, because we are assuming that this disturbance D, that particular disturbance is not exactly known to me, but I know the upper bound of the disturbance. I am not assuming that this disturbance is unbounded, and this V is velocity, and V mod V, that is drag force. So whenever underwater vehicle is moving inside water, then opposition force comes into picture. Now if you see this system, so this system is nonlinear system. And now you are able to understand why this is nonlinear, because I have one term, that is V mod V, and due to that region, this complete system is nonlinear system, and this is also uncertain. And what is factor of uncertainty here, this D? So D, I am assuming that D is due to the flowing water or due to other kind of disturbance, due to some kind of other modeling imperfection. So all kind of disturbance I am going to accommodate here. After that, you can see that now this system is nonlinear system. So if you see the literature, then I have two different classes of theory. One theory is explicitly applicable for the linear system, and after that, generalization of that theory, because whenever we are talking about nonlinear system, then linear system is going to include inside that, because meaning of nonlinear system is not necessarily a linear system. So it means that linear whatever theory I am going to develop for nonlinear system, that is equally applicable for linear system also. Means nonlinear theory is applicable for linear system, but that is not true that if I apply something for linear system and if I have very elegant result for linear system, that is equally applicable for nonlinear system. So that sometime that is possible, sometime that is not possible. Means generalization is very tough task. Now if you see the linear system, then in particularly linear system, whenever we are talking about, suppose I will take very simple example, I have some second order system, second order linear system, and output I have to track, that is y equal to 1. And if you apply input, and suppose initially your system is in rest, then you might have seen that during your classical control course, you might have seen this kind of graph. And after that, how basically we are specifying the desired behavior? We are seeing the rise time, settling time, and after that, in terms of frequency domain, we are talking about where the open loop transfer function is going to lie at low frequency and high frequency. So I have clear cut, or I have some kind of numerical way to measure the performance of system or behavior of the system for the linear system. But if you see the nonlinear system, then these kind of things is not going to work. And due to that reason, after applying the control, I have to analyze the behavior of the system, not like the linear system, means rise time, settling time, or these kind of things. These properties true due to linearity. Linear system is very, very simple. But if you talk about nonlinear system, then desired behavior people are specifying in terms of stability. And after that, they are talking about accuracy and speed of response. So accuracy means, here you can also see that when this particular, suppose I have some system and I have applied some kind of input, I am talking about single input, single output system, and whenever I have linear system, then I have this kind of response, linear second order system I have considered. So what is basic aim? That quickly I have to grab this particular reference trajectory. So, and accuracy means I have to maintain the closest vicinity of this particular tracking variable. So in nonlinear system, I have performance criteria or desired behavior. Most of time we are talking in terms of accuracy and speed of response. Speed of response means how quickly I can able to grab this particular reference signal. And after that, robustness is also very, very important, because most of time I have certain kind of unmoduled dynamics that is going to lie here. And after that, we are going to talk about cost, whatever building cost or whatever cost of the component. But in this particular lecture, I'm not going to focus on the cost. I'm going to talk about stability. I'm going to talk about accuracy and speed of convergence, as well as robustness. And I'm going to talk about highest form of robustness, that is insensitivity, by using or by applying the sliding mode control. So I hope that up to here, everything become clear to all of you. Anyone has confusion, then please let me know. Anyone? Okay.
No, sir.
Okay. Then now let us try to see. Again, I am going to repeat this slide, because I have already told you that in this class, I am going to talk about all different kind of stability. And first, before talking about stability, I have to talk about the what is meaning of equilibrium point. And if you remember the first or second class, at that time I have talked about this. Suppose I have no disturbance, and if I have just information of present, so I am going to scale that information, and after that I am going to apply here, and this is called, I have again feedback. So I have this underwater vehicle, and after that, what we are doing here, I am applying thrust. Whatever velocity that is going to come here, I am going to measure this velocity using sensor, and after that I am going to take the sample of this velocity, going to scale it, and after that I am going to apply this. And suppose I have some kind of tracking problem, so if some tracking problem, then this is reference signal. And after that, here then diagram is a little bit different. Then at that time, this is V. And after that, I have here whatever reference minus this signal, then I have to put inside this block. So suppose reference is 0, then V minus 0 is nothing but Vt. So I am going to apply K into V here. And using actuator, I am going to apply this to underwater vehicle. So this is our underwater vehicle. So in this way, I have two different kind of feedback. One feedback is called negative feedback, another is positive feedback. So I have applied here negative feedback, and after the application of this feedback, I have this kind of closed loop system. So this is first order autonomous system. So before talking about the stability, I am assuming that I have certain class of control, that control I am going to apply, and after that I am going to form the closed loop system. Now my system is represented by this kind of first order differential equation, and using geometrical method we have interpreted it that if you start anywhere on this real line. Why I have drawn real line? I have already told you that because this is just first order system. Due to that region, V belongs to R, and due to that region I have real line, and after that my initial condition might be on this side or this side. So just putting the initial condition in this particular equation Kp into V, so if you substitute initial condition here, then you are able to understand the instantaneous velocity. And if velocity and rate of change of instantaneous velocity I can calculate, so V I can interpret as a position. So if I interpret this as a position kind of quantity, then V dot is nothing but velocity kind of quantity. And after that, now what is our situation? That velocity is positive but rate of change, or you can assume that velocity is positive but rate of change of velocity, that is negative, and due to that reason I will move in this direction. So we have already seen this kind of things, and we have seen that I have very very unique point that if you start from here, then position like quantity, that is zero, also the velocity like quantity, that is differentiation of position, so this is not position, position like quantity I am assuming. So position like quantity is zero, and velocity like quantity, that is also zero. And due to that reason, if I start from here, I am going to stay here forever in absence of disturbance. And that from the first law of Newton, we have identified that as equilibrium point. And I have already told you that I can also generalize this same kind of concept for vector system, that x here, x is x1, x2 up to xn. So here this is position vector. So now x is position vector, and now if rate of change of position vector, this is velocity vector, and if this velocity vector is zero, so if velocity vector is zero, it means that if I start somewhere, then there is no rate of change involved, so I am going to continue there. So x dot equal to zero, it means that if a is non-singular, then x equal to zero. And so idea of equilibrium point, if a system start at a certain point in the state space or a space of the trajectory, and if they remains in that state thereafter, then that is called equilibrium point. And whenever we are talking about the equilibrium point, after that we know now that at least in any system I have certain kind of a specific point which has this kind of property, that if you are going to start, then you are going to stay there. That might not be a unique point. Might, in case of nonlinear system, we have already seen that this point might be isolated also or connected. Suppose that if you are talking about some periodic orbit or periodic circle, then I have infinite many connected point, and actually they are always oscillating. So if they once on this set, they are going to remains on that particular set. So equilibrium point for this particular system, first order system, that is unique, that V equal to zero. And so I am telling that in whole state space, just I have one point where if I start, I am going to stay there. And after that, now I am going to analyze the behavior of system in the vicinity of this equilibrium point. So now obviously, if we are in the vicinity of equilibrium point, then I do not have this kind of behavior. So equilibrium point have some fixed behavior, that if you are going to start there, then you are remains in that particular state thereafter. But if you start in the vicinity of the equilibrium point, then I have several different behavior. It might possible I will converge based on the situation, or I will diverge. So if you are going to converge towards this equilibrium point, if you start in the nearby of this equilibrium point, or if you start in the vicinity of this equilibrium point and you are not going to move far away, then that system is called stable. Or not particularly, if linear system, then stable, But if I have nonlinear system, then at that time I am just able to comment that the equilibrium point is stable. So equilibrium point of the nonlinear system is stable, because linear system I have track of everything, because due to linearity property I can able to understand the behavior in whole state space. But for nonlinear system I do not know the behavior in whole state space, and due to that reason we are talking stability with respect to certain point. So here we are talking stability with respect to the equilibrium point. So what we are telling, that if you are going to start in the vicinity of equilibrium point, then you have three different behavior. One different behavior is that if you start in the vicinity of this equilibrium point, you are going to remain in that vicinity. Second thing, that you not only remains in the vicinity, but you converge back to the equilibrium point. And third possibility, that you will diverge. So based on that, I have three different phenomena. That if I start, I am going to stay nearby. Second phenomena is that I will converge towards the equilibrium point. And third is I will diverge. So if you will diverge, then that is called notion of instability. If you converge, it means that we are talking about asymptotic stability. And if you remains in the vicinity of this equilibrium point, then that is called stability. And why asymptotic convergence? You are already able to understand from this particular equation that as trajectory is moving towards the equilibrium point, because v I have interpreted as a position like quantity, so v dot as a velocity like quantity. So once you are moving towards the equilibrium point, at that time what happens, that rate of change is going to decrease. So if you are in the very vicinity of this equilibrium point, at that time your rate of change is very very slow. So it takes very very large time to exactly converge to the equilibrium point. And due to that reason I am telling that my convergence trajectory is going to make some kind of asymptote here. And due to that reason, this kind of convergence is called asymptotic convergence. And asymptotic stability already satisfies the property of stability, because we are telling that meaning of stability is if you start in the vicinity of equilibrium point, you are going to remain there. So due to that reason, I have again recollected this slide. Now, in order to understand the stability, so in previous slide, we have understood the idea of asymptotic stability. Now, if you want to understand the idea of stability, then I am just going to put the disturbance. And I have already told you that disturbance is not exactly known to me, but I know that disturbance is not going to become unbounded. And due to that reason, I have written dt is less than equal to d0. And my closed loop system, I have represented like this for v greater than 0. So for other possibility, you can accordingly adjust the sign of this. And after that, what we found, that I have this kind of behavior, because in order to see the behavior, I have to track about two quantity. V is position like quantity, so I have to track about position like quantity, or I have to track v dot, that is velocity like quantity. Velocity like quantity. So that is not, I am not telling that v is exactly the position, but position like quantity, some kind of quantity I have. Now, if you are far from the equilibrium point, again you can see that why I am telling equilibrium point. Whenever you are calculating equilibrium point, at that time you forget about the disturbance, because when I have defined the equilibrium point, at that time I have told that in absence of disturbance, if there exists certain kind of point, if you are going to start from there, and if you are going to stay on that particular state forever, then that is equilibrium point. Due to that reason, whenever we are calculating equilibrium point, at that time we forget about the disturbance. So first I am going to remove the disturbance, and after that I am going to define the equilibrium point. So in order to define the equilibrium point, I am going to solve this differential equation. Again, v equal to 0 is my equilibrium point. Now I am going to see the behavior. So first I am going to start in the neighborhood of the equilibrium point, And suppose if I start little far from the equilibrium point, then I am going to show the behavior or see the behavior. So here you can see that as you start, then value of V0 multiplied with Kp, that is higher than this disturbance, because disturbance has certain kind of bond. So I am going to see those kind of region where Kp V multiplication of this negative factor is going to dominate over D, and for time being I am assuming D is positive. So what happens now, again in this particular region V is positive, but V dot is less than 0, because V dot, in order to calculate V dot, I have to substitute V. So I have this kind of motion, similar kind of things here. But if you start in this blue region, then you can see that V is positive, but at certain moment, because D, I am assuming that that is bounded by D0, so some constant bound. So there exists some time when this kind of phenomena basically comes into picture, that value of disturbance is going to dominate over our control value. And at that time, in this particular blue region, so right hand side, V is greater than 0, but V dot is, now what happens, V dot is also greater than 0. So both are greater than 0, and due to that region, greater than 0 means they are going to diverge. But once they try to go beyond this trajectory, again I have V greater than 0 and V dot less than 0. So they are not going to leave this, and due to that region, some invariant kind of set comes into picture. So if we are going to start anywhere inside this region, we are going to stay inside this region only. So we will move. Certainly we do not have behavior like equilibrium point, but now I have behavior that if I am going to start in the vicinity of equilibrium point, I am going to remain in that particular vicinity, and that particular bond is also called uniform ultimate bond. Uniform means for all time I have this much bond only, and due to that region, this kind of stability, that simple notion of stability comes into picture. Meaning of stability is, in simple language, that if you are going to start in the neighborhood of equilibrium point or neighborhood of some reference point, you are not going to deviate much. And if you see the practical system, most of time in practical system, what happens, I do not like this kind of stability. Suppose you have some kind of geostationary satellite. So I have to maintain that geostationary satellite in some specific orbit. So I have to maintain in some specific orbit. And suppose due to disturbance, if they will shift their shift from this particular axis, then or particular this trajectory, then what happens? Whatever purpose of this geostationary satellite, that will not satisfy. So what we are assuming, due to bad weather condition or due to some other factor, if their trajectory will disturb here, then finally after very long time, this trajectory should be converged to the original trajectory. If they will diverge here, then again they will converge to the original trajectory. So we need the another form of stability, that is called asymptotic stability. So now let us try to summarize it. So stability means boundedness of a state trajectory about the equilibrium point. That is the meaning. Now, whenever we are talking about asymptotic stability, it means that I have to make sure that my trajectory remains bounded. That is not going to become unbounded. Plus, my trajectory is also going to converge towards the equilibrium point. So asymptotic stability, in order to talk about asymptotic stability, we have to talk about two things. First, I have to talk about stability, because boundedness is ensured by stability. And after that, I have to also make sure that, suppose my system x dot equal to fxt, so this kind of autonomous system I have, then I have to make sure that xt tending towards 0 as t tending towards infinity. So this kind of things also I have to ensure. So apart from the boundedness of a state, I have to also make sure that this remains bounded. It means that I am also talking about equilibrium point is 0, I am assuming without loss of generality, So this kind of things will satisfy. So if x0 remains less than 0, then that implies xt minus 0 and absolute value of this. So I am assuming here just first order system. If you assume that I have higher order system, then I have to replace this absolute value by proper norm, and that should be less than epsilon. And so we are telling that for every epsilon there exists a delta, such that I will start from the smaller ball or ball of initial condition, you can tell, then I am going to live inside the delta ball. So we have already seen, so I am not going to again talk. So first we are selecting epsilon ball, and in this particular system I am assuming, I have already told you that in this particular system I am assuming that initial condition is my input and whatever output that is xt. So this is my autonomous system. So I am giving initial condition, and since this is autonomous system, so all states are reflected as a output. And after that, what we are telling, that if this output that remains inside the epsilon ball, and if this system is stable, then corresponding to every epsilon I can able to fix some kind of delta ball, such that if I am going to start from this particular delta ball, I am going to remain inside the epsilon ball. In case of the asymptotic stability, we are telling that we have another behavior, and that behavior is little more stronger behavior, that I am not only going to remain inside bigger ball, but I am going to converge to the equilibrium point also. And in third place, I am also talking about rate of convergence, because most of time, suppose in this particular application, I have to make sure that quickly I can able to regain my exact position. And due to that reason, rate of convergence is also very much important factor. So if you see the difference between stability, asymptotic stability, exponential stability, so one is talking about boundedness, asymptotic stability talking about boundedness plus convergence, exponential stability is actually talking about boundedness plus rate of convergence. Rate of convergence means exponential rate of convergence. And it is possible to show now that if some system is asymptotically stable, then obviously that is stable, because in order to talk about asymptotic stability, I have to talk about the boundedness. Similarly, if some system is exponentially stable, then that is also stable, as well as that is also asymptotically stable, because condition of exponential stability, that xt x0 exponential minus alpha t minus t0. So you can see that this will always satisfy second criteria also, that if t tending towards infinity and alpha is positive number, x0 is the initial condition. So and if you are going to write in form of norm, then please use here less than equal to sign. So you can see here that as t tending towards infinity, then this exponential stability things is converted into the asymptotic stability. And obviously exponentially stability also implies stability. So up to here, what we have seen, that I am able to talk about the convergence. So in asymptotic stability, convergence, rate of convergence, I do not know. I do not define, because I am telling that as t tending towards infinity, then my trajectory is converged towards the equilibrium point. In second place, at least I am able to define the rate of convergence. That is exponentially fast. We are telling that exponentially fast I am able to converge towards the equilibrium point. But still, I do not have track of time in this all three process. And due to that reason, this kind of things comes into picture. That is called finite time stability. So now, whenever we are talking about finite time stability, at that time, we are also incorporating the notion of time. And what basically we are telling, that suppose, again, I have some system, and again, I am interpreting in the same way, that I have two balls, that is epsilon ball and delta ball. And what I am going to do now, I am going to start from this delta ball. So whatever way I have interpreted in previous class, previous slide, that this is my x0 and this is my xt, and I am assuming that all state is going to reflect on the output, and after that I am telling that output ball is nothing but xt minus 0 is my equilibrium point without loss of generality. So this is my equilibrium point if that is less than epsilon, and here this is x0 minus 0, that is less than delta, this is some proper norm. So for every epsilon, so if you select this epsilon ball, corresponding to that there exists a delta. And after that, apart from this, I have one more phenomena, that if you start in the neighborhood of equilibrium point, if you start from equilibrium point, then, and suppose there is no disturbance, then you are going to stay there. Due to that reason, I have, you might have seen that I do not start from the equilibrium point. Most of time, I am starting from the vicinity of equilibrium point. And now, if I am going to converge to this equilibrium point in some finite time, then that is called system is, or equilibrium point is called for nonlinear system, or for linear system, if I have, then I can talk about whole system. Then if I have linear system, then whole system is finite time stable. But if I have nonlinear system, then I can only talk about the finite time stability of the equilibrium point. It is possible to show that nonlinear system only behave this kind of property, or going to process this kind of property, finite time stability. So in order to understand the notion of finite time stability, still this is basically inspired from the natural phenomena. So I have some kind of cart. Now what you are going to do, suppose that I have certain kind of friction in this particular road and cart is moving here. So some place I am going to, what I am going to do, whatever force I am applying, I am going to stop that force. Then what happens, after some distance, this cart is going to stop. And we know that if I have car and if I switch off my engine, and even if car is moving with any velocity, at certain time that is going to stop, and I am able to calculate that particular time. So I cannot tell that in infinite time my car is going to stop. That is going to stop somewhere in finite time. So if you see the mathematical equation, then you will get further clarity. What I am telling, that mass of this particular cart, that is m, and velocity of this particular cart is v. Now what I am going to do, I am going to apply the Newton's second law, force equal to mass into acceleration. So acceleration here, that is nothing but dv by dt. So I have represented dv by dt by vt in the same way. So due to that reason, this part comes into picture. After that, try to see this part. So this is called dry friction. So dry friction, if velocity, if something is moving in this direction, then this friction is going to oppose this particular direction. So that is the behavior of the friction. And if you see that dry friction, so dry friction is, this component is going to give the direction just. That if velocity is moving in this direction, then direction of this force, whatever friction force, that is in opposite direction. But this Kd is going to give the magnitude, means how quickly this, or how much friction force is going to generate by this particular process. So I have already assumed that I have friction. So I have this kind of dynamical equation. If you see this dynamical equation, then you can see that if v greater than 0, at that time I have dynamical equation like mv equal to kd, if v greater than 0. And if v less than 0, you can see that I have this kind of equation. V less than 0, I have this particular equation. If you solve this equation, so this is discontinuous differential equation. So either you can do solution like this, you can just break this equation in two ways. I am assuming that there is no need to worry about v equal to 0, because v equal to 0 is my equilibrium point. So I am just going to solve in both sides. It is possible to show that within this time, this cart is going to stop. So using solution, you are able to show this. Now here you can see that if you see the term of convergence, so mass is involved here, and that is the mass of this card. It means that if system is very very heavy, then I have to wait for large time such that this particular vehicle is going to stop. And KD is the friction coefficient. So if friction coefficient is higher, then what happens? That my time of stop is also lower. But if friction coefficient is very very low, then I have to wait for large time, because here friction is only responsible for stopping this vehicle. And if my initial condition, if I am far from the equilibrium point, then it takes very large time to stop, and due to that reason, this is the interpretation of this particular time. So you might have seen that if you are going to stop the truck is moving with some velocity, then it always take larger time to stop the truck, because road condition, so KD is fixed by road. So you can take one car or one very heavy truck, you are able to see this phenomenon. So what kind of observation we have now, that if system has this kind of dynamical equation, it means that right hand side is discontinuous, what we have seen here. Then I have some extra feature, that this particular, if you just now focus on this differential equation K signum V, then what we have concluded, that this particular differential equation has the behavior, and very very specific behavior, and that is called finite time stability. It means that trajectory is also going to remain bounded, and I can also give guarantee that in finite time I am able to converge to the equilibrium point. Now let us try to do another experiment. What you can do, you can put same card inside the water. So if you put inside the water, we have just seen the underwater vehicle, and what we have observed, that inside the water I have some kind of viscous friction force that is also acting on the system, and just now we have seen that is represented like V mod V. So either you can represent V mod V or V squared signum V, both are same. Again, this is in some case that is exactly equal to this. In some other case, that is proportional. It means that I have some kind of proportionality constant also involving with respect to this viscous force. So you can see here in this equation, right hand side, if you see, then if you are just moving on road, at that time only I have dry friction. But once I put this underwater vehicle, this cart inside the water, then I have this kind of dynamics. KD, KV, V square. So this KD signum V, that is due to dry friction. And after that, I have another term that is comes into picture, that is due to viscous friction. And if you solve this equation, so again, in order to solve this equation, there are two ways. One way, what you can do, you can use very very simple principle. You can define Lyapunov function V, that is capital V, that is V square. And after that, what you can do, in that particular language, V dot, I have V dot, and now V dot, if you substitute this, then I have KD, and whatever constant we are assuming, this constant KD and KV is positive, and V mod V. So I have now in place of V, signum V, so that is V. So now you can see that this is positive, this number is positive, and this is positive. So this is less than zero. So what we have seen, that if V greater than zero, because I have selected V, this particular Lyapunov function, in such a way such that is greater than zero, and if that V dot less than zero, then equilibrium point is asymptotically stable, and asymptotic stability also implies the stability. So similar kind of phenomena here I have, but apart from this, now I have different kind of phenomena. So if you solve this equation using any software or by using actually solving this equation by hand, that is difficult. So most of time we are using the software. So using software, either you can use Mathematica, and inside online also we have several way, several platform which is going to give the explicit solution. So if you use that, it is possible to show that this term of convergence that is defined like this, m pi root under kd and kp. So could you please tell me the difference between this term of convergence and this term of convergence? Saptiv, could you please able to see the difference between these two term of convergence? Saptiv? Ruchi? Ruchi, are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So could you please tell me the difference between this term and this term?
Sir, this time and previous time, sir.
Yeah. What is extra, what is your observation? If you see just now, you can focus this term and this term. Do you have any observation?
Sir, root under term is...
No. Root under m is known to me, pi is known to me, kd is known to me, kv is known to me. So in terms of the parameter or some other value, do you have any observation? Sunidhi? Are you able to see some difference between these two time?
Yes, sir. It is giving us the maximum time.
So this is also maximum because Vt is greater than zero. So maximum, yeah, okay. One is maximum. Another, that is one difference. That maximum time, it means that whatever time that is going to come into picture, that is less than this time. Okay.
It is dependent on the initial condition.
Yeah. That is very, very crucial. That is very, very crucial. That here you can see that this term of convergence is independent of the initial condition.
Yes.
But here that is depending on the initial condition. It means that now you can either put truck inside the water or you can put car inside the water. Both are going to stop maximum in this particular time, whatever will be the initial velocity. Okay, and that is also reasonable because you can see here that V square term we have. So V square term, because inside the water, I have higher value of the friction force. So friction force, so if your velocity is higher, then your opposing force is also very, very high. And due to that reason, this kind of phenomena comes into picture. So now what we have found that in this finite time stability, whatever time of convergence that is depending on the initial condition, obviously they will depend on the parameter. That doesn't matter because I know each and every parameter. Here, that is independent of the parameter. Due to that reason, this is a stronger form of stability because now we are claiming that you can start anywhere in the state space. In some finite time, you are going to converge. Here we are telling that if your initial condition is very far from equilibrium point, then you have to wait for larger time in order to converge to the equilibrium point. And due to that reason, you can see that fixed time stability also implies finite time stability. Why that is finite time stability? Because this process is going to complete in finite time only. So again, if you will define this kind of Lyapunov function and do that, here also same kind of things you can able to do. You can take same Lyapunov function and try to see that V mod V, because M is there, so you can scale every both side by M. Then M, I have MV. So if I will take Lyapunov function, that is MV square, like this. So I am going to write like this. You can able to take Lyapunov function like this also. Why I can take? Because mass is always positive. So if you calculate V dot, then M2V dot again comes into picture. And if you substitute this, then I have 2M and V and signum V, that is nothing but KD mod V. So again, I have less than zero. So stability is common because I am telling V is positive and V dot is less than zero. So I have a stability. After that, I am also claiming that V equal to zero, that is my equilibrium point. I am going to converge to equilibrium point in finite time. Now here, I am telling that, okay, time of convergence, again, that is finite, but that is independent of the initial condition. So that is the difference between finite time stability and fixed time stability. Fixed means whatever your initial condition, okay, whatever initial value of your system state, you are going to converge to the equilibrium point in finite time. So this kind of observation we have already discussed that in finite time, convergence time is not uniform with respect to initial condition. Uniform means for any initial condition, if I have some upper bound of time, then I am telling that convergence is independent or uniform with respect to initial condition. So fixed time stability, we have this kind of behavior. But still, you can see here that based on the parameter, I am able to talk about the time of convergence. And this is maximum time of convergence. So suppose if you are applying this kind of control, suppose I will come to that point in later part. Just you try to understand this. Suppose this is my initial velocity V0. So what we are telling that in maximum time T max, whatever will be the initial condition, that will converge. So I cannot able to talk about the exact time. I am just able to talk that, okay, if I start anywhere, then I have some time, but maximum time is not going beyond this particular limit. So that is going to remain somewhere between this, but still I do not know what is the exact time, because this is just talking about T max. So exact things is still not known. So now what is our question? Our question is it possible to create differential equation where time of convergence, so something is not visible here, uniform with respect to the initial condition. So so they have some kind of behavior like fixed time stability, means whatever time of convergence that uniform with respect to initial condition, as well as uniform with respect to parameters. Without worrying the parameters, if I am able to select the time of convergence, then that is called free will. Free will means based on your will or based on your expectation, now you are able to tune the new time or time of convergence to your system. So let us try to see in terms of control. So now what I am going to do, I have already told you that somehow if you are able to develop theory for first order system, then by recursive way, I can able to apply that kind of theory for higher order system also. Because in case of sliding mode control, we have already understood this. Suppose this is my system. So we know that x2 equal to minus ax1 is going to stabilize this particular system, this subsystem. Then after that, I have defined sliding surface like this. And again, I know one algorithm for first order ax dot, and several times you might have seen that I am equating that with k signum s. And using that, what I am going to do, I am going to design the control. Then you can see that if we are able to understand the behavior of this subsystem, first order subsystem, and again I have first order algorithm, combining both algorithms, I am able to develop control for second order. Similarly, I can able to proceed for higher order also. And due to that reason, most of time, whenever someone develop theory, they target first the first order system. So same kind of system I am going to target, that x and u both belongs to R, and this is my initial condition. Now what I am telling, I am going to design control like just based on the proportional information, and that is negative of this. And it is possible to show if you do MATLAB simulation, then, and if you just zoom this trajectory, it is possible to show that every time you have a asymptote on the origin, they never going to meet. Whatever, you can go to any extent and try to do the zoom, you are able to see this. Now, what I am going to do, in place of u equal to minus xt, now I am going to apply this. It is possible to show that if your initial condition is 2, then time of convergence is 2. If you are going to start from 5, time of convergence is 5. So try to see from here also, you are able to become convinced that if kd equal to u 1 and m equal to 1, so m by kd, what is m by kd then? M is 1 and kd is 1. Then what is ratio of m by kd?
1.
And for that reason, time of convergence is exactly, because this is greater than equal to V0. So exactly I can able to guess that is same like initial condition. And due to that reason, this simulation also confirmed the same fact. They are telling that T is greater than equal to mod X. So if you start at 2, then you have to wait for 2 seconds. If you are going to start for 5, then you have to start for 5 seconds. And similarly, if you are going to start at any higher value, then you are able to get that kind of things. Now, what I am going to do, I am going to now take little complicated equation. So you can see this equation, that what I am going to do now, this, or you can write in the standard form. So same like super twisting, if you remember, signum x1, and after that now here I am going to add one more term, and this term mod x 3 by 2 signum x1. So this is my differential equation now, x1 dot. So if you solve this differential equation, it is possible to show that time of convergence, that is greater than equal to pi. So, and in order to solve, I will tell you that how to solve. There are some standard way. So one way that you can use any software. So most of time, whenever we are developing some complicated differential equation, at that time we are solving that equation using the help of some software only, because solution process is most of time that is not so easy. So it is possible to show that T is greater than equal to pi. It means that pi means 3.14, and you can see that I have started with same initial condition 2 and 5, then they are converged before the 3.14 seconds, because maximum time of convergence is 3.14, and due to that reason I am telling that I am not able to claim that exactly what time I am going to converge if we are just talking about fixed time stability. Okay, why fix? Because here time of convergence is independent of initial condition. Okay.
So T should be less than equal to pi or greater than equal to pi?
T should be less than equal to pi. Sorry. So here this is less than equal to pi. Sorry. Thank you for the correction. T should be less than equal to pi, because we are talking about upper bound. Due to that region, T should be less than equal to pi. Any confusion? But here we are not talking like that. Due to that region, this inequality is true, but this inequality is wrong, because we are talking about the upper bound. Anyone has confusion? Okay. Now, what we have done, another thing in our mind, that try to create some kind of differential equation such that I am able to control the time of convergence. And from any initial condition, now I am going to give guarantee that within some time I am going to converge. And for that, using autonomous differential equation, that is not possible. You can see that this equation is autonomous. This is also autonomous. Why I am telling autonomous? Because we have already remembered the definition of autonomous system. X belongs to Rn. And whenever we are talking about non-autonomous system, we are going to incorporate the time also. So if you are going to become some more flexible, we are also going to use the information of time. And if you create this kind of equation, so you can see that this is a little bit complicated. E power mod x minus 1, e power mod x tf minus t, signum x. And tf is the time of convergence. Whatever time you want to select, you can select. Suppose if I select t equal to 0.1 second, then within 0.1 second, suppose you are able to apply that much of control, then you can start with any initial condition you are going to converge in that particular time. And due to that reason, this stabilization process, stabilization, why we are talking about stabilization? Because we are going to design the control. So this is the key of the next whole talk. So whatever things I am going to talk, I am going to talk with respect to this equation. You can see here, since in denominator I have tf minus t, and what is t? T is the time that is going to progress, and tf is my final time. So once t equal to tf, at that time this become infinity, and due to that reason I have put here less than equal to tf. It means that once I am in the very close vicinity of TF, at that time I am going to switch off my control action. And it is possible to show that if you will do this, then T equal to TF, if you start anywhere, you are going to convert. So I have selected T equal to 1 second in this process. So TF equal to 1 I have selected. And after that, what happens? That X equal to 0. It is also possible to show that not only X, X dot also equal to 0. So rate of convergence, I am also talking about XT and X dot T. So both position as well as velocity equal to 0. Up to here, anyone has confusion? So this is the equation. So most of time, you can see that whenever we are developing equation, then some intuition is required. So if you see that, suppose you have some kind of rocket and you have certain kind of target, and if you want to hit that target with that target using some rocket, and suppose you do not know the initial condition, but you want to hit that target in some kind of fixed time, and most of time is very, very crucial. It is possible to show that somehow in optimal control, some exponential kind of form of control comes into picture. From there, it is possible to guess this kind of equation. Now, let us come to the next development. And why this kind of things is relevant in terms of the sliding mode control. So we have already discussed that sliding mode control has one very beautiful property, that if you apply minus K signum V, and if K is greater than dt, then I have this kind of phenomena, and I have already explained this kind of so geometrical interpretation is same like Newton's, and but here just geometrical interpretation is going to change, that instantaneous velocity is non-zero but average velocity is zero. And we have already seen that based on average velocity, so we have developed so much thing. We have developed the equivalent control. Based on that equivalent control, we are talk about the observers, we are talk about the differentiators, we are also talk about the integral sliding mode control. So due to that reason, here I am assuming that average velocity equal to 0. So same kind of phenomena, you can see that if vt equal to 1 you can take, then in finite time we are converged to the equilibrium point, and at that time my control is discontinuous. And if you pass through low pass filter, then what happens? By passing an equation of low pass filter several times I have written, so I hope that become clear to you. And ut is here control, so ut means whatever k signum x you have, please pass through that discontinuous term from here, and after that whatever equivalent value of z, that will give you the value of dt. In that way I have reconstructed this. So in order to reconstruct disturbance, you can see that I can able to reconstruct this disturbance only in finite time. But most of time, whenever you have fault, it is better that if we will reconstruct this disturbance in fixed time or freewheel time, then process become more significant. Because most of time, whenever we have fault, we want to identify that fault as quickly as possible. Due to that reason, fixed time estimator is required. So let us try to see that how to modify classical sliding mode control, or as well as higher order sliding mode control, using the idea of freewheel time stability, such that I have some kind of freewheel arbitrary time sliding mode control. That is the main goal of today's lecture. So before going to that, once you detect some phenomena, then you have to first talk about what is meaning of that phenomena. And due to that reason, we are using the definition. And again, meaning of definition is actually motivated from somewhere, but definition is just telling us that I am going to believe on this. So definition, whenever you are writing some definition, it means that you are telling that we are going to believe on this, and after that whatever things I am going to develop, if that will satisfy this definition, then that particular property comes into picture. And due to that reason, you can see here that I am talking about generalized system, because in order to talk about fixed time freewheel arbitrary time stability, I have to talk about non-autonomous system. And non-autonomous system means I have to talk about some system where time is there and as well as state xt is there. In this particular way, what I have done here, I am going to incorporate delta. Here I have used very wrong notion. This kind of notion should be not used inside function. So please interpret this like this, tx and delta like this. So this is function of time, function of x, and I am telling, okay, suppose I have this particular right hand side is also function of some parameter. So I am going to incorporate the information of parameter also. So what is meaning of finite time stability? That x0 is globally asymptotically stable. Globally means if I start anywhere in the state space, I am assuming that asymptotically, or as t tending towards infinity, I will converge to the equilibrium point. And you can see here that how basically I have defined the equilibrium point for non-autonomous system. So for non-autonomous system, I am going to put trajectory xt equal to 0. I am assuming that this equal to 0. So that is the definition of the equilibrium point for the non-autonomous system. Now, in order to talk about finite time stability, and we know that finite time stable system is also asymptotically stable system. Why? Because in asymptotic stability, I am telling that xt, that is tending towards 0, as t tending towards infinity. And in finite time stability, we are telling some stronger condition, xt equal to 0 as t greater than equal to t. So you can see that this particular quantity is actually inside this. So whenever I have this kind of notion, then I can tell that finite time stable system is also asymptotically stable system. But not vice versa. In this way, I cannot claim that all asymptotically stable system is also finite time stable. And due to that reason, inside definition, I have 2 points. So I am telling that x0 is the globally asymptotically stable, because now I am trying to search those kind of stability which is uniform with respect to initial condition. So I have to consider all initial condition inside some ball or some kind of whole space. So first you can consider that my whole, now I am going to talk about whole space, that is Rn. Now you can see here that time of convergence t should be greater than t0 when you are going to start your experiment, plus tau is the settling time. So if you are going to establish this kind of relation, then your system is called global finite time stable. Global or local means if this true is not this result is not true everywhere, then we are talking about local finite time stability. But if this result is true everywhere, then we are talking about global. But since I have to talk about uniform with respect to initial condition, due to that reason, global is required. Everywhere we have to talk about global thing. Now, if x equal to 0 is globally finite time stable, now you can see that these two properties satisfy. And we are also going to talk that there exists some maximum time. So just you can see that some correction is done by Ruchi, and at that time, she told that tau should be greater than tau max. So this is actually implies from this definition. Here, I am talking in finite time I can converge. Here, whatever finite time, I am settling time. So this is my settling time and this is a starting time of my experiment. That should be less than equal to some maximum time tau max. If that condition is satisfied, then we are going to tell that x equal to 0 equilibrium point is fixed time stable. So now you can see that fixed time stable system also implies finite time stable, because in order to talk about fixed time stability, first I have to talk about global finite time stability. But this direction may be true, may not be true. So this, if this condition is satisfied, then obviously system is globally finite time stable, globally asymptotically stable, and stable, or globally stable, you can tell. Now, what I am going to do, I am going to coin some new definition that is called arbitrary time stable. So what is meaning of arbitrary time stable? That now we are just very much sure about the time of convergence. You can see that everywhere we are very much concerned about the settling time. So what we are telling that, okay, suppose my system is fixed time stable, so they will satisfy this kind of property, and this tau a, whatever tau a means, this settling time, that is depend on the delta. So delta is nothing but some kind of parameter. It is possible to assign arbitrary tau a by making allowable variation in system parameter delta. So you are going to tune delta, and based on that tuning, you can able to adjust this settling time. So what I am telling, now apart from this control, inside control I have some kind of parameter. Here control means initial condition, you can assume, because whenever I have autonomous system, non-autonomous system, at that time we are seeing the response of system with respect to initial condition. So here I am going to apply the initial condition, I am going to set some time t0, and after that what I am going to do, I am going to set this parameter, and based on the variation of parameter, if I am able to adjust this time, so maximum time if I am able to adjust, that is called tau a, then what happens, this system has two different property. If tau a is greater than tau tf, and what is tau tf, that is this time tau max. So by variation, what I can do, I can able to tell that tau f is exactly equal to tau tf. So suppose by varying delta, I can able to fix this time tau a equal to 1 second. So this, what this inequality is telling, that you are only able to fix time because I know now upper bound of time. So once you know the upper bound of time, then now I have to fix time somewhere, because this is fixed time stable. So I am telling, okay, this is the maximum time under within which trajectory is going to converge. Now what I am telling, by varying parameter, I can adjust or exactly tune the time. If you are exactly able to tune, then that is called arbitrary time. If not, then that is called weak time arbitrary. Now try to see the next definition. In next definition, what we are telling, that tau a, which is independent of any system parameter and can be stated priori. So what I am going to do, now we are not telling that this time of convergence is function of any parameter. Independently, during the control design only, user can select. There is no need to tune whenever some time will change. Just you can put that parameter. So if you are exactly able to do, then that is called free will, a strong arbitrary time stable. If not, if this greater than equal to, then that is called free will, weak arbitrary time stable. So what happens, that most of time, if you see the system, their dynamics, whatever dynamics we are capturing, that is, we are using some kind of ideal theory. So most of time, whatever mathematical model, that is not perfect. So I cannot tell that perfectly I am going to tune, but I can tell that, okay, whatever time of convergence, that is going to lie on their vicinity. And due to that reason, instead of a strong arbitrary time stable, we are talking about practical arbitrary time or weak arbitrary time. Practical means those which basically comes into picture after the implementation. But we are going to tell that that time is not much larger, whatever time we thought, that is in the vicinity of that. So that is, in that way, we have defined this new definition. So now I hope that this definition become clear to everyone. Anyone has confusion on this definition? Then please let me know. Okay. Now what happens, that all free will arbitrary time stable system is arbitrary time stable. Arbitrary time is fixed time stable. Fixed time is globally finite time. Globally finite is globally asymptotically, and finally stable. So in this way, these all definition is cascaded inside one by one. Okay. So it means that if you make in form of set, then suppose that if I am telling that system is stable, after that I have some smaller set inside this stable region, that is called asymptotically stable. Inside this set, I have some region where we are going to talk about exponentially stable. Inside that particular set, now what happens, I have another sometime it might possible that finite time stability, so exponential stability also. Due to that reason, now I am going to make some kind of set where this kind of intersection is also allowed. So that is finite time stable. Now inside finite time, I have fixed time stable, and inside the fixed time, now I have some kind of set that is arbitrary, and inside this, that is called free will arbitrary. So in this way, I can able to cascade all form of stability. So anyone has confusion? It means that those system which is going to satisfy this class of stability, that is very, very limited. But by designing control, you are able to enforce this system which will behave like this. Now, let us come to the, whenever we have developed something or some observation for a scalar system, and we know that if I just understood the theory for positive system, because using Lyapunov theory, I understood that if I know that some system Vx is greater than 0 for all x, and V dot x along the system trajectory, this is less than 0, then I am able to characterize the picture of stability from the system. And if less than equal to also, and if after that, if I have further different inequality, then I am going to talk about finite time, fixed time, and after that free will. So I am able to do. Due to that reason, what I am going to now consider, just I am going to see the system, and what I am going to do, this scalar system means x belongs to R, and I am just going to consider the positive system. I am not worrying about any other class of system. Means when x is positive, then what is behavior? And if you see the solution of this, it is possible to show again using software that this is the solution. And after calculating the solution, you have to verify that whatever result that is given by software, that is correct or not. So what you can do, you can differentiate this, and it is possible to show that again you will recover same equation. So in this way, whenever we are getting some data from software, we are checking where k is defined like this. Now from here, you can see that I can conclude that if this eta, that is greater than 1, and if that is not greater than 1, then I have another different kind of things comes into picture. Because what I have to do after that, I have to substitute here this quantity. And if you can see that if I select eta that is less than 1, then something is going to dominate in the denominator. Due to that reason, I am going to select eta that is greater than 1. So any eta you can select that is greater than 1, that will work here. It is possible to show that as t tending towards tf, so as t tending towards tf, then this. So corresponding to any initial condition, and if I will fix tf equal to 5 seconds, suppose I have selected, and I have started experiment as 1 second, then this some number comes into picture, and suppose initial condition of this is 5, because I have just considered the positive system. So I get this number, and once you substitute this number, because this number is going to generate initially, and after that you can see that as t tending towards tf, at that time this quantity become very, very small, and once this become very, very small, then finally I have ln equal to 1. So as t tending towards tf, then x is tending towards 0, and x is 0. So from here also you can check, now x is 0, very, very close to 0. So what happens, that e power 0, that is 1 minus 1. So finally x dot is also equally at the same time, that is tending towards 0. So x and x dot both tending towards 0, and after that, so now what happens, that at t greater than tf, I have situation like this, x t that is very, very close to 0, x dot is also very close to 0. So if you solve x dot equal to 0, then solution is nothing but x equal to 0. Due to that reason, I can switch after t greater than equal to tf. Because I have, if some kind of equation I have x equal to 0, then solution is xt equal to c. But I know that as t tending to tf, So I am very, very close to zero. Due to that reason, constant, whatever constant I have, that is very, very small. And I can tell that that become further small. Due to that reason, that is nothing but zero. And that kind of conclusion, by seeing solution, I can able to conclude that this equation has that kind of property. Now, try to see the control also. So it might possible someone might think that as t tending towards tf, this control become very, very huge. But that is not the case. Why? Because e power x is tending towards 0. So e power x minus 1, that is also tending towards 0. So I have 0 by 0 form. So whenever I have 0 by 0 form, it is possible to show that they will create some kind of finite limit also. So in this process, it is possible to show that due to 0 by 0 form, I have certain kind of finite limit. And I can also able to calculate this bond. It means that as k less than equal to 1, this initial value less than equal to 1, at that time, u is bounded by some constant number. This is eta, whatever gain you have. If that is greater than t0, then u is less than equal to eta into k. So in this way, we are able to create this kind of band. So this calculation is actually done by Anil. So very nice calculation. He has shown that whatever control, initially people are thinking that control become very, very huge. And due to that reason, we have done this kind of calculation. Now, let us come that whenever we understood the behavior of a scalar system. So now I am going to copy that behavior inside Lyapunov equation. And now, using Lyapunov equation, in this particular lecture, I am going to remove the proof part. I am just going to give you the intuition. Since now system is linear, system is non-linear time varying system, non-autonomous system. So non-autonomous system, if you are talking about the uniform stability, at that time you have to make sure that whatever Lyapunov function you are going to consider, that should be radially unbounded. So radially unbounded means as x tending towards infinity, so vtx also tending towards infinity. So you can see from here, that is, one can see if Lyapunov function is bounded like this, then that is called radially unbounded. One more thing, if vtx, that is greater than k1 mod x power a, here t is not included, then that is called positive definiteness. So if some Lyapunov function is positive definite, and if suppose that is also containing the information of time, then you have to make sure that that is positive definite, provided that will satisfy this kind of inequality, k1 x1 power some number a. And this is called decrescent. Decrescent means we have some kind of upper inequality also. And again, you can see that t is not included here. And at equilibrium, that should be zero. That is perfectly same. Now, I have to make sure two things. I have to make sure that system is stable. Due to that reason, v dot should be less than zero. So you can see here that a negative sign is here, eta is positive, and here e power k3 mod x power a. So this quantity is always greater than 1. And all other quantity, because t is lying between t0 to tf. Due to that reason, this denominator is positive, numerator is also positive. So negative sign is here. So I have this kind of things. That is obvious. V dot less than 0. Due to that reason, system is stable. And if you will give some more flexibility, that inequality will satisfy this kind of condition, then this particular equation or particular inequality, if you just remove less than equal to by comparison lemma, it is possible to show that that is equivalent to this inequality. And in place of k3 mod x a, if you substitute from here, then that will again express in form of v. And exactly this kind of equation comes into picture in form of v. We will see in the next part of this particular slide. Somewhere I have shown that by taking Lyapunov function, again we will get this kind of equation. And if we will get this kind of equation, I have already told you that x here greater than zero positive system. We are just talking about a scalar positive system. So I can able to talk about fixed free will time stability. And due to that reason, if Lyapunov function will satisfy this, then system is free will time stable. So So now you do not need to worry. You have to just define Lyapunov function. Again, all properties should be satisfied. Just you have to make sure that this condition will satisfy. So if this is less than zero, then that is called weak freewheel stable. And if that is exactly equal, then that is called a strong freewheel stable. So most of time, whenever we are talking about strong, we are talking about ideal situation. But whenever we have realistic situation, at that time we have practical stability. Now let us come to the one system which is going to show this kind of behavior. So I have constructed some system. So I have constructed system like this, and I am assuming that this function theta xt. So if you replace x1, then e power x1 minus 1 e power x tf minus t. So this kind of equation comes into picture. So whenever you are developing some theory, then you have to develop some kind of system. So most of time, first people are developing some kind of mathematical system, and after that they are searching some kind of physical system also. So first step, I have constructed some system. So what I am going to assume that I have some kind of Swiss system. So between TF, I have this kind of dynamics, and after TF, I have this kind of dynamics. Now, using Lyapunov theory, whatever we have developed, using that theory, I am going to prove that this particular second order system is freewheel arbitrary time stable. So again, I have to construct Lyapunov function, and here in this particular system, I am assuming that g dot t is always less than gt. So whatever rate of some function that is less than original function, that kind of things I am assuming, and I am assuming that function is always positive, that never become negative, so lie between 0 to k. So this kind of assumption I have, and eta 1 and eta 2 greater than equal to 1 I am assuming, because somehow I have to construct those kind of system which is freewheel arbitrary time stable. So I have taken this kind of Lyapunov function x1 square plus I am going to incorporate this term 1 plus gt, because g dot we have seen that gt is differentiable. Due to that reason I can construct like this. Now first step, you have to prove that there is positive definite. So since this is time varying Lyapunov function, so you have to show that vtx, that should be greater than equal to some kind of norm x power a. And here you can see that if you take two norm, then at two norm x1 square plus x2 square, and in place of a if you put half, then this kind of things comes into picture. And similarly, since gt is maximum value of k, so one can show that this Lyapunov function will satisfy whatever first property, this kind of property is satisfied. So this is obvious now. And x equal to 0, now whatever Lyapunov function I have constructed, so if you substitute x equal to 0, then x1 equal to 0 and x2 equal to 0, so that is also proof. Now just I have to make sure that will satisfy third inequality. So if you take the differentiation and if you substitute everything, and I am going to analyze first in this particular time interval, and after that, after switching, I will do separate analysis. So in after this time TF, I have to just show that x1 and x2 is going to maintain at equilibrium point. That kind of things I have to make sure. So either here you can see that I have constructed differential equation in such a way such that whatever system I am going to generate after t equal to TF, and I am going to show that system is asymptotically stable. It means that, and since I have asymptotically stable system, and why I will prove using Lyapunov function why I am telling that that is asymptotically stable. So I have to prove that. So what I am going to do, we are going to write this particular system, that particular system is like x1 minus x2. So this system I have to prove that is stable. And stable, and if since x1 tending towards 0 and x2 tending towards 0, and that is 0 is we are actually very vicinity of equilibrium point, so I am going to maintain at that point, that I have to show. So first you can do analysis in this region. So in this particular region, you can first take the derivative, and after that it is possible to show that this kind of relation comes into picture, where phi 1 and phi 2 I have defined in that particular way, where theta I have already defined like this. And so all just is the calculation. So what you can do, please check this calculation. Now since v dot is less than equal to this term, so I can tell that is also less than this, and less than this. So what happens? Suppose I have some quantity V that you can take 5, and if that is less than 2, this is positive quantity and this is positive quantity is possible to show, then it is possible to show that is less than each individual quantity. So same kind of things I have done. And what I am going to do, I am going to show here, since I have x1 and x2, so at some time, if you are somewhere, then since you are in two-dimensional plane, so it might possible the value of x1 is higher and x2 is lower. And at the best moment, I have equal value, x1 equal to x2. So if x1 equal to x2, then inequality, you can take anything. But if x1 is greater than x2, then you can, out of max, you can select one and corresponding inequality will satisfy. Now you can define new variable as a row in this way. And if you do differentiation, you can see that same kind of form comes into picture. So finally, what is our aim? Whatever things you are going to define, finally, you have to convert your system in this particular form. And if this kind of form comes into picture, then I know the beauty of this form, that this form always force system equal to zero, rho equal to zero in this particular time, t equal to tf. So same kind of property. So finally, we have shown that between this, now v equal to zero. So once v equal to zero, now what I am going to do, I am going to analyze this system. So v equal to zero, it means that x1 and x2 both equal to zero. And now I have this kind of dynamics. So either you can do Lyapunov analysis, same Lyapunov function you can take. Again, you can able to see that v dot less than zero, and you are already at equilibrium point. So you are not going to leave that equilibrium point. And to that reason, I'm telling that this system, whatever system I have constructed, mathematical system, that is free will time stability. So what is your task? You can take this system and do all kind of calculation and verify that whatever calculation I am telling, that is okay or not. And how to verify? You can just check these three inequality. These three inequality you can check, that is satisfy between t0 to tf or not. And after t0 to tf, you have to also show that system remains stable. That kind of things you have to show. Now you can see that how to incorporate this idea to sliding mode. So what we are telling, that since if I have just this kind of system x dot equal to minus k signum s plus dt, then I know that if I start from any initial condition, I am assuming that this xt belongs to R and this is time axis. So if I start anywhere, then in finite time, I will converge. But that is function of x0 means that is initial condition of this. So if I will construct some kind of algorithm such that I can able to control the time, such that I can tell that, okay, within this specified time, if I will converge and also I am able to mitigate the disturbance, then algorithm has some extra beauty, and we are going to explore that beauty only. So what we are going to see, do that, we know that system behavior of system after t greater than equal to tf, that should be exactly equal to their same behavior. And due to that reason, you can see that after t greater than equal to tf, I have switched to same algorithm. And we already know this fact, that dt, and if xt equal to zero for some time when we are going to start experiment t equal to tf, so that going to maintain. It means that if we are at the very vicinity of equilibrium point, I am going to stay there forever. So this part is going to ensure second part. First part, now what I am going to do, I am going to just add one extra term, and theta tx we have just defined here, that is e power x minus 1 e power x tf minus t. So that is my theta xt. So in place of now x, s, we have x, so we have this kind of e power xt minus 1, and after that e power xt and tf minus t. So I have this kind of situation now. So you can see here that now I have to prove that, again, free will kind of stability comes into picture. So for that, and why this kind of things is required, because again after t greater than equal to tf, I am going to apply some kind of low pass filter to reconstruct the disturbance. So now I can fix the time. So suppose somewhere fault comes into picture, so I can tell that within 2 seconds I can able to identify the fault. Another important thing, suppose you have some kind of device which will follow the first order dynamics and I have uncertainty, I can tell that within some specified time. Suppose I have rocket, so in a specified time I can able to hit the target, because now I can decide the time, and in between anywhere I can able to change the time information, TF, final time I can update. So by updating time I can hit in a specified time. So again this equation is differential equation with discontinuous right hand side, because here now you can see that I have added extra kind of switching. After that again I will take same Lyapunov function, and using that Lyapunov function I have same kind of structure. And we have already proved that if you have this kind of structure here, if you have this kind of inequality, so defining this kind of variable again exactly I have form of free will. Due to that reason you can see here I have skipped that calculation, since here k is greater than mod d, so this kind of, so I can do not include this part, because this, if I remove some kind of negative quantity from v dot, then inequality still remains the same. I can use that kind of idea. And after that, now you can see that I have this kind of inequality, and finally again it means that x equal to 0 in some time, that is t greater than equal to tf. So exactly at that particular time I can able to make sure that x equal to 0. It means that by constructing or passing discontinuous signal, so now just I have to pass this signal, because after t greater than equal to tf my system dynamics is shift to this particular dynamics. So again whatever classical theory we have read, and whatever Professor Utkin has given the form of classical sliding mode control, that is valid. So just what is role of this particular term, that is going to give now flexibility to control any process in some specified time, that is the beauty. Now similarly, suppose if you have second order system, so now you know that if I design u based on some Levant way or some kind of twisting control, then I can able to make sure that x1 and x2 equal to 0. I have also talked about one algorithm, that is nested algorithm, that is based on weighted homogeneity, so please check it. So if I have this kind of system, and if I will apply this kind of controller, second part of controller, we have already seen that for any initial condition x1 equal to 0 and x2 equal to 0, you are able to converge to the equilibrium point in finite time, but that time of convergence is function of x10 and x20, because that is just finite time stability. So if you apply u equal to minus k signum x2 k2, so this is nested form of controller, or terminal sliding mode controller also you can interpret like this. So if you apply this kind of control action here for all t from a starting point onward, then whatever time of convergence, you are not able to control that time of convergence. But if you add this extra term, you can see here that what I have done between t0 to tf, I have added this extra term. So it is possible to show that by adding this kind of extra term x0, and I can able to control the convergence rate of x1 and x2. Due to that reason, this is second order free will arbitrary time stable system. It means that this is, I can achieve higher order sliding mode control in free will way. That is the meaning of this particular slide, and how basically we are doing this. Now you can see that I have some kind of system x2 and x2 dot equal to u. So first you can forget about the disturbance, and what you can do now, you can just consider this subsystem. Now you can design x2, you can select, that is eta e power x1 minus 1, and after that e power x1 and x1 and tf minus t. In this way you can select. So if you select this, then you know that here this update comes into picture, and after that x1 equal to 0 and x1 dot also tending towards 0. Now what you can do, you can define the sliding variable, that is the same like Now, whenever we are defining sliding variable, we are defining this plus this number. So you can update this number here. And again, what you can do, you can apply the classical sliding mode with respect to sigma 2. So in this way, it is possible to so I will define this as a sigma 2. Here negative I have defined because already that is positive comes into picture. And after that, when you will do sigma 2 dot, then x2 dot plus whatever differentiation of this variable comes into picture. It is possible to show that within this particular time interval, this variable, whatever this variable, that is also differentiable. I am not talking after t greater than or equal to tf, but before that, that is differentiable. And due to that reason, now x t equal to u comes into picture, and in place of x2 equal to u, whatever extra term you can substitute here, and after that d, so k signum sigma 2, so first order sliding mode control comes into picture, and after that you have to make sure that this k should be greater than dt. Then finally again I have first order kind of sliding mode, and after that you can switch to the, since this is second order system, so switch to the second order sliding mode. So in this way I can talk about the second order sliding mode control in freewheel way for the second order system. So basically this algorithm is developed by us. Still there is no use of, we haven't used this algorithm for any practical purpose. So those who are working on practical system, power electronic, they can directly use this kind of control, and they will show that this kind of phenomena, finite time stability in freewheel time, that comes into picture. And proof is again very much straightforward. So please just check it. Now, what I am telling for convergence, so again, if you will check by hand, then only you are able to understand each and every step. So please do that. After that, we have simulated this. So what we are going to do, we are going to consider the first order system, and after that second order system, and we have taken this kind of disturbance also. After that, with initial condition x0, now we are going to take different time, and you can see that exactly you are able to achieve that particular time. Now here these three are the simulation for the second order system. So second order system, first we have taken 4 seconds, after that you can see here 6 seconds we have taken, and after that this is nearby of 8 seconds. You can see here that something so before 8 seconds that is going to converge. So in this way, using just writing simple MATLAB program, you are able to achieve this kind of graph. So now this is time for the conclusion. So far in this particular lecture, what we have seen, that we are able to understand that what is meaning of stability, asymptotic stability, finite time stability, fixed time stability, and freewheel time stability. We have also able to understand the connection between those things. One more thing, I forget to mention, that I'm going to tell you, that suppose that now, because here we have already seen that if something is asymptotically stable, at that time I have relation like v dot equal to v should be some form alpha into v. So if I have this kind of equation, then we are able to talk that by solving this I can achieve asymptotic stability, or more general result is like this: v dot less than 0, then that is asymptotically stable. And after that, what we found, that if something is finite time stable, at that time I have gamma, and where gamma lie between 0 to 1. So this kind of dynamics, if that comes into picture, then I can claim that here v equal to 0 for all t greater than equal to 0. So we have already seen by solving this, it is possible to show that if you have this kind of equation, v dot x, that is less than equal to minus a vx power gamma, where I am assuming that whatever vx, that is this kind of condition, they will satisfy, and vx tending towards infinity as x tending towards infinity. And I am also assuming that v is continuously differentiable at least one time. Then it is possible to show that if that will satisfy this kind of inequality, a vx power gamma minus b vx power alpha, and if you select this a greater than 0, b greater than 0, and after that if you select gamma, that is lie between 0 to a, 0 to 1 and a, it means that gamma you have to select, that is lie between 0 to 1, and whatever alpha I am going to select here, this is alpha. So if that is greater than 1, then if you check the solution of this equation, then solution directly I am going to write, it is possible to show that time of convergence that is less than equal to 1 by a 1 minus gamma minus 1 by b alpha minus 1. So with positive sign here. So you can see that if you have this kind of differential equation, whenever you are defining some kind of Lyapunov function and you are getting two differential equation, and if power of that differential equation in right hand side, if that lie between 0 to 1, means I have finite time stable kind of situation. And apart from that, if I have some kind of equation where alpha greater than 0, then solution of this Vx equal to 0 in this particular time. And here you can able to calculate the maximum time by 1 by a, whatever parameter you can put, and 1 minus gamma lie between 0 to 1, and after that 1 by b, and this alpha that is greater than 1. So in this way, you are able to calculate the time of convergence for this particular differential equation. And this is the Lyapunov theory for fixed time stable system. And now from this here, you can see that I can able to remove any term. So if I remove this term, second term, then that is exactly same. So this part is exactly same to finite time stability. Due to that reason, we are telling that fixed time stable system is also finite time stable, because Vx is converging, and when Vx comes into this limit 0 to 1, then at that time, suppose I have 0.01 power alpha, and alpha is half gamma, and gamma you can select half, then that becomes 0.1. But here if power is higher, suppose that is 2, so or 3, so at that time that is 0.01 power cube. It means that value of this term is very, very less. And due to that reason, we are telling that in the vicinity, when convergence occurs, at that time, this term is finite time term is going to dominate over second term. When Vx is very, very large, at that time, this term will dominate. So that will force trajectory to converge towards the equilibrium point with very high speed. So that is the role of this particular term, and due to that reason, we are getting fixed time stability. So this is theory for Lyapunov theory for fixed time stable system. So now we are able to understand the Lyapunov theory for everything. I'm again going to repeat that if V is Lyapunov function, and we know what is meaning of Lyapunov function, and if V dot less than equal to 0, then system is stable. If V dot less than 0, then system is asymptotically stable. If V dot will satisfy this kind of relation, then that is exponentially stable. If V will satisfy this kind of relation, V power gamma, then and gamma lie between 0 to 1, then that is finite time stable. If that will satisfy this kind of relation, just we have written Vx power gamma b Vx power alpha, and we have seen that this gamma lie between 0 to 1 and this alpha is greater than 1, then this is fixed time stable. So this is fixed time stable, and we have just seen the condition that V dot that is less than equal to minus eta e power v minus 1 e power v tf minus t between t0 to tf. So t should be t0 to tf, and after that, if this become equal to 0 or any other form, if they will switch. Now you can select any form, either asymptotic stable form, exponential stable. So switching, after t greater than equal to tf, you can able to select any kind of stability. Then system is fixed time stable, previous time stable. So in this way, you are able to analyze the stability of any system using the framework of the Lyapunov. And so here I am assuming that Vx greater than 0 for all x, and for global thing, x when x tending towards infinity, Vx should be tending towards infinity. So that is called radially unbounded condition. So with this framework, we are able to understand the stability of all nonlinear system. So after that, with developed mathematical approach, what we have done, we have see the difficulty, we have analyzed, and we have also talked about at least one application, but there are several applications in defense or other things. So what you have to do now, you have to explore the other application, and implementation is still, so we have done one implementation in our lab, so we have two tank system, so we have implemented that. But you are able to do a lot of application in the power system, power electronics, and due to that reason I have presented this particular particular lecture, because now at least this theory is very, very new, so you can able to implement to your system once this course become over. And now I will show you some basic paper this interface is visible to everyone.
Yes, sir.
So you can see that this is first paper which is appear in Automatica. This is one of the flagship means publication in control system. So Automatic Control and Automatica has a lot of value. So we have published this paper, and after the publication of this paper, we have also extended this result for multi-agent system. Again, that will if you see the impact factor of this transaction, that is very, very high. 11, I think that is very, very high, quite high. And after that, we have extended that kind of same kind of concept in IEEE transaction on circuit system. So either you can go through this paper, and after that, discrete implementation part is actually done by my Chinese friend. This is Jiyong. So with Jiyong, we have developed that how to implement same kind of things based on the discrete time framework. Because whenever you have microprocessor or this kind of things, so this kind of things we have done. So now let us come back to again the conclusion part. So if you have now any confusion, then please let me know. So what basically we have seen in this particular lecture, that I have various different form of stability. In order to develop theory, if you are willing to develop some kind of theory for nonlinear system, then you have to just select some beautiful positive scalar differential equation, and based on their property you are able to give some new theory. So every day people are searching some new scalar differential equation which has some different property than whatever today I have talked. Okay, so if you are able to find some kind of differential equation, a scalar differential equation which has some further property, then you are able to develop, or you are able to coin some new direction also. This particular lecture is also benefited in several ways. You are able to understand whatever stability theory that is developed for nonlinear system. After that, you are able to understand the new concept, how one can develop the new concept. You are also able to see that how several different notions of stability are connected, and what is using Lyapunov way, how to do different analysis. So with this remark, now it is completed from my side. If you have any question, then please let me know. So sorry for the long lecture again. So do you have any question?
Sure. The main theory is taken from that Automatica paper.
Yeah, that is taken from Automatica paper. So please go through that paper. Actually, inside proof, there is some correction, so you have to go through two Automatica paper. So one more Automatica paper is actually submitted. Actually, one author is commented, they found that one in one place, we have some mistake. We have done mistake. So after that, we have corrected that mistake. So we have two Automatica paper in this direction. So if you open one, then second paper is already suggested by Automatica, that you have to read this paper also.
Okay, sir.
So if you do not have question, then I am going.